Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm John Gray, and I'm just plain living here.
Good morning, John. I'm Peggy Burton.
And I'm Jim Fuller.
It is nice to be here.
It's
beautiful
weather.
It is
nice to be living here.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes, absolutely.
I bet you had spooks at your house yesterday.
I didn't get home till a little bit later, but I understand there was a couple of hundred there yesterday and the last night.
I live out in the country, so I just have to watch them on Facebook or TV.
And, of course, I was at work, and I get three at the office, my grandchildren.
Yeah, they always
because they always come by, and there's money involved.
Right.
And so,
they know that Grandpa have a handout.
Yeah, that started because several years ago I had not prepared, and we didn't realize that nobody comes to the office to trick or treat. And so I had to give them money. Now that's sort of a tradition.
That's what they want.
I wish all I had was money, don't you?
Anybody have sugar shock this morning?
Not me.
It was funny. I was watching the Today Show or one of those shows in there a minute ago, and they were talking about how you deal with the sugar high or low or whatever it is that these kids are all going to school on a sugar hangover. And they ask what do you do to help remedy that? And like most things that you do too much of, one thing is hydrate. Mm-hmm. It's good to hydrate, and protein.
Right.
Are good to eat a lot of protein to level those levels of sugar out. And they were asking, now what do you do? And so they even had a thing of Michelle Obama and Barack Obama saying yesterday it's okay to eat candy today. They had a presidential
meeting
presidential permission to eat candy yesterday. And so they were asking around, we'll say, okay, that was yesterday. There was about four of them sitting there like this talking. Say, how do you get the candy out of your house? Because yesterday was okay. Today you need to be good again. And one old guy says, well, I eat it. he was a big old football player type guy, and said, how do you get the candy, do away with the candy in your house? He said, real easy, I eat it.
I love it when they show pictures of the parents that have hidden the candy and saying, there's no candy, and then they'll show the kid and the tirade they go into. Have you seen that?
No.
It's, somebody does that, and I can't remember what show it is. It's really cute. It's really cute because the kid just goes crazy because they're not getting their candy.
They're getting their candy. And we had a real good celebration of the downtown remodeling.
Yes, it was.
Last Thursday, and we'll have some video of that. And that leads up to the fact that yesterday was Trick or Treat Downtown. And I think Candy said the couches, they had 1,000 pieces of candy and used all of it.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And it's funny, my sister-in-law, Candy Couch, one of her friends, gave her a shirt that says, Instant Witch, just add candy.
Yeah.
And Candy's wearing it.
Yeah, that's
so
cute.
I thought that was a pretty good shirt.
It was. So, that's a great thing they do downtown, though. It's a safe environment. And several of the cities, I know Manchester, does that as
right,
well.
Right, safe on the square is what they call theirs.
Yeah.
Yeah, because nowadays parents have to critique the candy and all the stuff that comes in the bag.
Oh, sure.
The kid knocks on just every door. So, it's kind of scary.
I remember when we would trick-or-treat on Druid Lane when I was a kid. And, of course, that street, every house on that street had children in it, from 1 to 6. And the coolest one to go to was Dan Wagner's house. Dan and Steve and Ann and Jane Wagner's house, because Miss Wagner made the best cupcakes on the street.
Yeah.
And that's what she gave for Halloween, was these wonderful cupcakes. Homemade cupcakes with icing. Now, you can't let your kid have stuff like that because they'll put razor blades in them or tacks. It's terrible that what parents have to go through to see what their children get, unless you're going to kin folks or something like that, but you just can't accept that from a door coming behind a door that you don't know who lives there.
That's true. Well, you don't really have any business there. And this time in the world, you shouldn't be going to somebody's house where you don't know the people.
Well, they truck them out
not
to
with
tell
children.
Oh, my,
I know
out there at Kings Ridge, they come from all over Winchester. I mean, there's cars lined up out there to go through Kings Ridge. because they think the candy's going to be better there than in some of the other places. And that's just crazy.
It is crazy. Everything gets out of hand day and age.
And I wonder if the clowns were walking around.
I haven't heard
any clown stories. I really haven't.
No clown stories
for Halloween. I had stories before, but not now. So I guess people did not dress like clowns. We still had a lot of clowns, but they weren't in costume.
They weren't in costume. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
What about your football team, Mr. Fuller?
Tennessee, yeah. Things are kind of in disarray there at Tennessee right now, aren't they? Bad weekend, certainly against South Carolina. I guess the big story out of Tennessee, though, is that Jalen Hurd, their star running back, is leaving the program. He's a junior.
And they hate that.
Yeah, and I heard you and John Olive talk about that one time. That's kind of a thing that didn't used to happen, but it happens all the time now as young men. Well,
somebody changed their mind.
Yeah, they'll change their mind and go do something else. And it happens in high school as well.
It usually happens when they lose their job.
Sometimes
it's pretty simple. When you're not the feature running back anymore, you're going to go somewhere where you are. And that's exactly what happened to him.
You could be right about that because I don't know if he's hurt or what. Maybe he has some injury.
His feelings are hurt.
But obviously the other two running backs have been more productive in the last few.
Well, and he was touted before the season. I mean, as one to be watched, maybe even into the Heisman viewing. And he hadn't performed like that.
Right.
So, I mean, that's just that business is a cash business, man.
Yeah.
It's just like the pros.
You think sometimes that they ask to leave or maybe they are asked to leave,
I doubt he would have been asked to leave. He's a good athlete. There's no question about it. But John said, hit it there probably a moment ago. You know, when you don't get quite as much playing time as you'd like.
Sure.
For whatever reason, you know, you have a tendency to change your mind. Seems strange that he would do that at this point, though. He's a junior. There's, four or five games left.
A lot of them leave as seniors.
Yeah.
Even the ones that graduate and still have a year of eligibility left, if they're at a school that's not successful, they'll go to another school and not even go to school, but they have an eligibility year left. Or maybe they're studying, taking a few courses toward their master's or something.
Right.
And that's just like Steve Matthews up at Knoxville. He was going to be the starting quarterback at UT. And who was it came in?
I forget. It was...
But there was another quarterback came in, took his place, and he went to Memphis.
And did well.
And beat Tennessee. When Tennessee went to Memphis, he beat Tennessee.
Right.
Don't you know how good that made him?
Sure it did.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know,
absolutely.
Get replaced and then come over here and I'll beat you.
Yeah. Exactly. Well, Hurd, though, is a junior, and he's probably going to go pro after this year, I think. But
he's going to have a better year than this.
He'd probably be a third, fourth round draft pick probably after his junior year.
Yeah.
But he says he's going to go to another school and try to play tight end. And I believe
that's what he needs to be, because he's not quick enough to the hole to be a college or a pro running back.
That's what it sort of looks like, and you're more familiar with the game than I am.
Yeah, but that's what it sort of looks like. Once you plant your foot and head upfield, you got to get there.
Yeah.
And he's like Eddie George and some of those big tall runners. Their legs, their foot speed's not fast enough to get them to the hole quick enough.
Right.
By the time they get there, it's closed.
Yeah,
because that game is instantaneous.
I guess
aren't you enjoying this?
I love that. I just doze off.
You only have to tolerate this about once a month.
That's all right. No, I don't mind. I just go off and think of other things, like Dancing with the Stars.
He does a 4.40. It must be his acceleration.
But that happens 20 to 40.
Right,
it doesn't happen in the first 5 yards, and that's what gets you through the line of scrimmage.
And that read option offense that Tennessee runs, I wonder if that's really conducive to back of that size.
Uh-huh.
You know,
no, it's Kamara. That's Kamara's game right there.
Yeah.
All right, now Peggy, what about Peter and the Starcatcher?
It's coming up this weekend. It opens Friday night at 7:00, Saturday night at 7:00, Sunday at 2:30, and next weekend
And that's at the Civic Center.
At the South Jackson Civic Center, and you can get tickets online, or you can call 455-5321-931 if you live out of state or somewhere and you actually get this wonderful show, then be sure and call in for tickets.
Right.
Or I guess you could show up at the door even.
Yeah, and you Peter Pan fans out there, what it is a prequel to Peter Pan.
Right.
It sets up why Peter Pan happened. And I think that's pretty cool.
They have a really good cast, and Tullahoma High School did this recently. And it's a popular play for young people. And I'm an old person, but I'm going, but I'm taking some young people.
Yeah.
And I think it'll be fun, because I enjoy what they do.
And, you know, that kind of stuff is happening. I know they did three Batman things, then they did Where Batman Came From, how Batman got to be Batman. And now there's a movie coming out pretty soon. I think it's Magical Beast and Where to Find Them, which is Jay the Rowling, who wrote Harry Potter.
Oh, that should be exciting.
What happened before Harry Potter.
They're just stretching the idea.
They're stretching that franchise.
Which is smart.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's very smart.
A gazillion-dollar franchise.
Anytime they, do another one. It works.
And of course, that thing, the animation and the costuming and the megatronics of that whole deal is just phenomenal.
It is phenomenal. I don't know how they do it.
It's just incredible.
And it gets a cult following is what it gets. They grow up and grow into it, and then they can't wait for the next one. That's pretty nice for the writer.
Yeah,
the producer.
Heavens yes. So
smart thinking.
What we're going to do right now is take a quick commercial break, and we'll be back with the rest of today's show. Don't you go away. We're going to have some fun here.
Today to think about what I was physically before and what I am now, and I don't ever want to go back to that original situation.
The overall mission of the rehab team is always what is best for the patient and how we can facilitate maximum potential from every resident.
Well, the most important thing to me is that I'm allowed to do whatever I want to do,
Everyday Miracles, Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
The Tullahoma Animal Shelter's 13th annual Bark in the Park fundraiser is Saturday, October 29th from 10 to 2 at Wagner Park. It's a day of family fun to raise money for medical care for dogs in the no-kill shelter. Sponsorships, silent auction items, and volunteers are needed. Admission is free and tickets are available for games and food. If you'd like to help out, contact Teresa Holt, 931-454-9580, Animal Control at TullahomaTN.gov, or visit the website.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with news leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and we're pleased to have joining us now Katie Issue, who is the head person of and the originator of the 41 Toy Convoy, and that's coming up this weekend, Katie.
Right. It's this Sunday, and I'm really excited. Everybody I have talked to from my previous show entry list, everybody was already planning to come before I called them, so I think it's going to be the biggest turnout we've had in a long time.
It always seems to get bigger and better every year, no matter what. You started this, you originated this program when, Katie?
Basically, back in 97, we had a motorcycle group, 41 Abate, and they folded after 3 years, and so it was either stop the convoy, because I was already organizing it for them, order to keep it going, and we chose to keep it going.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's been, this is our 20th anniversary. I know a lot of people thought it was going to last 2 or 3 years and then disappear.
That's unbelievable. It really is.
We got the longest running event around here, so I'm really excited about that.
It's interesting. I just want to get this little tidbit in, but it's interesting. You said you had a motorcycle club when you first started this. If I remember correctly, you actually ride motorcycles.
Yes, I do. Yeah. I've been riding since 1974.
Okay.
I'm an oldie but a goldie. I ride a lot. but one thing we wanted to do different than everybody up here in Tennessee does, we wanted to invite everything that rolls, cars, bikes, trucks, vans, hot rods. We didn't care because I remember when I didn't ride, standing on a street corner, watching all these bikers go by, and I'm like, I want to do that, but I didn't have a motorcycle,
right,
so I couldn't do it.
Right.
And so I said, there's no reason for somebody who wants to do this and help us, you know, not be able to just because they don't have a motorcycle.
Right.
So we invite cars, bikes, trucks, vans, hot rods, motorcycles, big rigs, everything. We got rat rods coming in this year, and they told me they're bringing with them 2 truckloads of toys. Just 2 guys that I spoke to. They have been collecting toys throughout the year, so they're going to be bringing all sorts of toys with them this year. And I think I've got a 99-year-old retired FBI agent coming this year. So he'll definitely win the Young at Heart Award.
I think what you're watching on the screen, folks, is video from some of the past events as we're talking here. So,
yeah, this was back in, I can't remember what year this was, but as you can see, there's a little bit of everything that comes in. And we ask everybody flies the American flag in, to salute our military. There's a lot of guys still overseas that would like to be home, be remembered at Christmas. So as y'all can see, there are some awesome rides that come in for this run.
Now, the purpose of this, let's be clear about this. Purpose of this is because, and the reason it's called Toy Convoys, because you're trying to get people to bring toys.
Everybody is asked to bring a new unwrapped toy or two, whatever they can afford. And it's the toys go out through the Sheriff's Department, Tullahoma Fire Department, Manchester Police Department, and I take some toys over to Bedford County. And they distribute toys throughout their system that they have set up. Kind of got too much for me.
Well, I can imagine that would be a huge job because
I didn't want to do that.
I mean, you get like a truckload of toys.
You get a big truckload, and it's really hard when you start, you know, trying to distribute, because we still have to break the toys up for the boys and girls so somebody doesn't get all boys and all girls, you know, but we distribute it evenly.
Now this starts over in Manchester, right?
Right.
At where?
Raiders Academy. We're going to line up at Raiders Academy. That's located on Highway 55 at the interstate. And lineup starts at 11, but these guys have turned it into a cruise in. I get there at 10. There's people in the parking lot already set up. And they hang out in the parking lot, and at 1 o'clock we roll. We have a police escort to bring us down Tullahoma. And it's really funny because coming down the road, you get some long dips. And so you're looking in your rear view mirror, you don't just see 1 or 2 cars, you can see a lot of the line.
Right.
And when you see the American flag flying, just really touches your heart.
Sure.
That many good people have come out, you know, to help the children. And we have a new venue this year. We're going to end at London's. And the city's closing Lincoln Street from Jackson over the railroad track for us, and then down at the crossroads of Atlantic. And we're going to go 55, hit Jackson, come all the way up through town. Now, we leave Manchester at 1 o'clock, so if you want to get along, if you can't join it, you can at least come out and see it. And we go past the mall, hit Atlantic, and backtrack downtown to Lincoln. And then the show will be along Lincoln Street, and the band will be set up at that little park. I call it Lincoln Park, next to the alleyway there. And we've got door prizes that the local businesses have donated. And we've got some really nice things coming this year. We've had some new sponsors jump on the convoy. And last year we gave away 2 laptops, a notepad, a bunch of dinners for 2. Uh-huh. I hear this year we might have an Xbox. Maybe a TV.
Right.
And we've got, leather vests, a couple of helmets. We've got some really nice door prizes we're going to be giving away.
And once you get to London, it's kind of a little unwind party.
It's like a street party then. Everybody walks around, looks at all the vehicles, and, voice who they think should be winning. And then we've got some beautiful trophies this year. They're going to be the American flag thing because the election's just a couple days after the convoy.
Right. Right.
And we do want to encourage everybody to get out and vote. And but we did choose the American flag theme for the trophies this year. It's going to be really nice.
Okay. And we might mention, we got just a few minutes here, just a minute here left, but you don't have to call and make arrangements.
No.
All you got to do
is
show up at the Radio Academy.
Right. It's $10 a carload. If you have 3 or more kids, you get in free.
Mm-hmm.
20 if you want to show. You get 10 tickets towards your door prize drawings, and we'll be doing that all throughout the afternoon. We've got a Duane Allman tribute band this year. We'll be rocking the afternoon away.
Oh, yes.
And it's going to be a lot of fun. And I'm really excited because this year the weather's going to be sunny and 74 degrees, plus Lincoln Street is in the sunshine.
Right.
And that's going to be, they went by there yesterday and they said it was just pure sunshine.
Yeah.
I said, yes, it's going to be great.
All right, it's going to be a lot of fun, folks, and plus it's going for something.
Lineup starts at 11, we roll at 1, and everybody, all vehicles are welcome, large and small. We've had semis down to motorcycles, so y'all please come out and join us.
All right.
It's great. And thank you, Jimmy, for having me on here.
Well, it's our pleasure. It's a great, great cause that you're promoting there. And a lot of young children are going to really benefit from that at Christmas time. So get out there and do your part. And help them out. 41 Toy Convoy coming up this Sunday, November 6th. We'll be right back in just a moment with more Living right after this.
Hi, I'm Mike Winton, and I'm running for state senate for the 16th District of Tennessee. Raised by a single mother who worked multiple jobs to raise our family, I understand the value of hard work and the obstacles met by many members of this district. Because of this, I'm committed to ensuring that you have access to education and health care. Whether I'm on a mission trip or running my business, I always remember it's about our witness and not about me. Be sure to vote for me, Mike Winton, so that our district can win with Winton.
This ad paid for by the candidate.
I see a train a-coming. It's rolling up the track. And it looks like that train's loaded with a real good Democrat. Mike's headed up to Nashville. That's where we need him to be. And if we all vote for Winton, we'll finally have a state senator who really represents you and me.
Be sure to vote for me, Mike Winton, so that our district can win with Winton.
Here at Manchester Funeral Home, we know the importance of living and working in our local community because it's those families who we serve during their time of need honorably. We believe in supporting local business and offer only 100% Batesville caskets, the best in the industry and a driver of our local economy. If you want straightforward and fair pricing while working with the people you know, choose Manchester Funeral Home, serving your community since 1932. And pre-planning and pre-funding can be the best gift you ever leave your loved ones. Call us to pre-arrange. Manchester Funeral Home, our family caring for your family since 1932.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play, what you wear, how you dance, or even what direction life takes you. You just need to be there. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
How long has it been since you raced a cheetah? Are your tornado creating skills getting rusty? Tired of being the only one in your neighborhood who hasn't built a dinosaur? Sounds like it's time to visit the Hands-On Science Center. Hands-On Science Center is an indoor science playground. In this museum, please touch is the rule. Join us for weekly science demonstrations on space, lasers, lizards, rocks, and a whole lot more. No two visits are ever the same, so visit often to see our ever-changing exhibits and demonstrations. The Hands-On Science Center, 101 Mitchell Boulevard in Tullahoma.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this last week there was the Chamber Coffee, and it was Jim Woodard's, I think, 20th time of having Belgian waffles to celebrate his trip to Belgium to buy diamonds. Let's take a look at the video. And it's Woodard's Diamond Showroom here today, and they're celebrating Belgian waffles at the Chamber Coffee. All the notables will be here. There's all kinds of fun to be had. Announcements will be made. There's Joe right there. He's country. He's cat country. That's how country he is. You know, so it's just getting started, and we'll get an interview with Jim. The tables are all set up for Halloween, and it's Belgian waffle time. All right, and here's the waffle room, the breakfast room right here. We've got Belgian waffles and pretty smiles and hungry faces. Him hat bell boy over there. He's going to get him something to eat. I'll guarantee you that. I
promise you that.
Man, look at that bunch, huh? They got waffles and they got sausage, sheer up and all that good stuff and coffee. And all right. Belgian waffle time, Woodard's Diamond Showroom. Of course, there's the chamber chick right there. She's getting everything lined up. There's Mr. Woodard right there. We're going to corner him in a minute and get some verbiage out of him. Yeah, here's Jim Woodard here. It's Belgian waffle time, buddy. How's it going?
Oh, John, listen, it is October, so it must be about time for Belgian waffles and actually diamonds from all over the world, John. So I'm glad you're here today. But, hey, you know what this is?
What is it?
This is my 25th year as a business.
25 years.
That's why I'm wearing this extra little nicer outfit today.
I mean, you're looking sharp today, too, buddy.
We are trying to celebrate 25 years of Woodard's Diamonds and Designs. So it was 25 years ago that Woodard's opened. They had a little girl named Anna on the ground and had stone in the oven cooking. And all of a sudden, I was told that my store was going to be closed and that I would not have a job in about 3 months. So with that being said, I had to get busy and find somebody to loan me the money to buy the business to open up Woodard's. And you know what? That meant a lot to me, and it meant a lot to our family. And that would not have happened if it had not been for this community and all of you that have supported me. 25 years says a lot, and with God's blessings and God's favor, I hope to be here another 25, because I want to be like the Couch family. You know, that's what I want to be. And I don't see the little Miss Couches over here. I still have fond memories about that. As far as a business question, this celebrates 30 years. The waffles are about going overseas and buying diamonds. Today, Woodard's buys diamonds from all over the world. It's not just Antwerp anymore. It is Russia. It is Mumbai. It is also Israel. So they come from all over the world. We've also added this year Levion. If you all are familiar with that wonderful brand, Levion, they've been in the jewelry manufacturing business for 500 years. That name and that family has been making jewelry. So we've added that. Because of people like you, and if you want to look around and kind of look at each other and think about each other, again, it is a great, it's the people that make the community great. Lots of great things going on in our community.
It's time for every family and business in Tullahoma to go green and recycle. Tullahoma Public Works makes it simple and easy to recycle. Just place your recyclable materials, paper, plastic, aluminum, and cardboard beside your garbage container on the same day your garbage is picked up. Your recycled materials don't have to be in a fancy container. Recycling is not only the right thing to do, it makes sense. Recycling pays. Paying to bury our garbage costs each of us. Please do your part. Let's go green, Tullahoma, and recycle.
Hi, I'm Cindy.
And I'm Jacob.
I'm the Rooster.
And I'm the Red Mate. And we would like to welcome you to
Roosterware.
Yes, Rooster Wear is a cottage industry producing accessories for men, women, children, babies, and pets. All items are hand-cut and sewn locally. Rooster Wear specializes in bow ties, pocket squares, scarves, cufflinks, neckties, and aprons of all sizes for all ages. Baby products include onesies, diaper covers, bibs, and burp pads. All bow ties, tie-it-yourself, or pre-tied come with an adjustable neckband. All products can be made with a material of your choice, as special orders are available upon request. Don't be standing back looking at fashion. Create your own with Rooster Wear.
Come visit us at
roosterandredmaiden.com
to find our handcrafted designs for
the cock of the walk.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your News Leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back, and I don't know if you'll remember, you might not, but a year or so ago, or three, Dr. Duncan from the high school, and she wasn't quite Dr. Duncan then, but she is now, came over and talked about starting a Renaissance program at the high school. Well, we're excited today to have four young people in the studio that are part of that Renaissance program, and we're going to introduce them to you right now and talk about what's happening with the Renaissance program and how things are going with them and how the program is expanding. So welcome to our show. Thank you, young people, for being with us. And there's one more sitting out there, and she's out there for moral support. What's your name, dear?
I'm Kelsey Kyleman. I'm a sophomore.
Uh-huh.
I'm Adeline Carson. I'm a freshman.
I'm Jordan Jones. I'm a freshman also.
Okay. And so the Renaissance
Action Team.
Action Team is a group of young people who are tasked to do what?
We're trying to make the school a better environment for everybody and try to have them enjoy being at school.
Enjoy being at school. Then how did you get involved?
I was originally approached by Mrs. Morris, who is a freshman English teacher, mm-hmm. and she wanted me to join because she thought I was a good leader.
A good leader. So the first members of this were asked by teachers to be involved.
Yes.
Yeah.
And how about you?
Well, I got involved originally because Ms. Sisk, one of the teachers in charge, she just made us in our advisory. She just made us do Renaissance Action Team tasks, and I got interested in it, so I was like, can I join? And she was like, sure.
Jordan?
I was approached by Ms. Sisk and Ms. Morris because they wanted me to join because they thought that I had good leadership skills and I was known around the school.
Okay, but someone, this is not a... an inclusive club. It's a club that anybody, or action team, that anybody can be involved with. If you want to join, you can join.
Mm-hmm.
And that hopefully what you're trying to do is make the experience of going to school more fun, more educational, where you can get the most out of it you can without being pushed, pulled, bullied. Make the whole thing a good deal for not just for this group, but for everybody, right?
Right.
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Okay. What are some of the things that you are trying to do to reach that goal?
Well, the first day of school, the Renaissance team leaders, the teachers, put together a day where it wasn't just about, okay, we're going to introduce the students to their syllabus, we're going to tell them everything they can't do in school, everything that they have to do in class. They instead decided that they would bring everybody into the gym on a half day, and they would just have fun. They would play games with us. We would get to do a bunch of action-type games with everybody.
Yeah, they were like, oh, they involved exercise. Like,
mm-hmm. We all need more exercise.
Yeah.
Even young people. Mm-hmm. Even young people. So by the end of that day, though, did you have the information that you normally would have if they would have done it the old-fashioned way?
No, they moved that day to the next day.
And oh, okay.
We all really enjoyed that.
So, good. So, I read where your teachers, I think about 10 of them, went to a seminar about this to learn what they could from other schools and other people who had been doing this Renaissance program. And they brought back ideas. And then when do you get together? How do you decide what you're going to do?
The meetings are every Thursday, mm-hmm. without fail. It's every Thursday in the afternoon after school. And we basically just bounce ideas off of each other and figure out what we can do.
Okay, and I saw something also in the literature that they sent me about a Renaissance card.
Oh, yeah. Basically, every quarter, a student will either get a card or not. And the card tells the student what they qualified to get into the Renaissance
Renaissance Rewards Club kind of a thing.
It's not really a club. It's more like if you have all A's and B's, if you had perfect attendance, if you just had all-around excellent student behavior.
If you raised your GPA by 5 points.
Yeah.
And so what's on the card?
The card basically is just a little card, and you can go around to different businesses in Tullahoma and get rewarded for it.
Or
you, like in school, I think people get free parking passes.
You can get free entrance to all the school sporting mm-hmm. events.
Yeah, so it is a rewards type system for you being a better student, a better person. What about do you go out and do y'all go out and solicit membership? It's not membership, and do y'all go out and say, hey, why don't you come to our meeting with us? Why don't you be in? How are you trying to get people involved?
Well, sometimes we put on really cool events, like during pep rallies, and we say it's sponsored by the Renaissance Action Team, so maybe that'll get people interested.
And you're gonna have a band play?
Yes, that is one of the attractions to being allowed into the Renaissance pep rally.
Okay, so I think Cody Quillen and William Cubitz are two of the people that are involved in the band that's going to play. And they were on our show, I think, 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago. And then they impressed me to the point I got them to play downtown for the celebration that we had downtown. And they're very, very talented. So for all you folks out there, you want to see these guys, and if they've got a band put together, go to the Renaissance event. Excuse me.
We originally got the idea for the band when when the teachers brought 20 students to the Jostens Renaissance meeting. Well, it wasn't really a meeting. It was more of a group of, there was like 1,000 people. There was a lot of people there.
Yes.
And it was in Hendersonville?
Hendersonville.
And they basically just taught us about what we can do to improve our school. And they gave us ideas for Renaissance.
Good. Well, that's wonderful. And what do you want to say to anybody out there in television land, the parents of some of these young people? How make a plea to them to have their children become part of Renaissance?
We really just ask parents that they support Renaissance to their children, because we are trying to make it better for them
right.
as students. So
having them be a part of it would really give us more ideas to what we can do for them.
Right. And so this is not for the singers, it's not for the dancers, it's not for the play people, it's not for the athletes, it's not for the math, the number heads. It's for everyone.
Indeed.
Yes.
To have a better place, a better environment, politically among each other,
yes.
Friendship-wise, I think it's outstanding. Yes. Thank you so much for doing what you do. And know that you're welcome anytime to come back here and talk about anything you want to. And I do want you to do that. If you're gonna have an event, keep us posted where we can help you promote it, okay?
Okay.
Thanks so much for being here, and I'm proud of all of you.
Thank
really
you for
am.
Having us.
And you too, for your support out there. All right, we got a big thumbs up. Who is that? Who is that?
Oh, that's Sid. Sydney.
That's Sydney. Sydney's out there with a thumbs up. All right, folks, we'll be back after these messages.
So you've been meaning to do something healthy, commune with nature, get outdoors and meet new people. We have the perfect solution. Come hike with us. You can find a Tennessee Trails Association chapter near you, including Clarksville, Columbia Franklin, Highland Rim, Jackson, Knoxville, Oak Ridge, Memphis, Murfreesboro, Nashville, Plateau at Crossville, and Upper Cumberland. We're on the web at TennesseeTrails.org. It's fun, it's stress-free, and it's good for you. See you on the trails.
Tired of paying for monthly telephone service, expensive long-distance bills, and all those crazy taxes? Are you sick of spending money on telephone equipment, maintenance contracts, and service calls, all for a phone system that shackles you to 100-year-old technology and your desk? Stop it. It's time to ship your phone system to the cloud. What can the cloud do for you? Bring together remote offices, workers, and employees in the field. Make sure that you'll never miss calls by delivering them to multiple devices. Modernize faxing by allowing multiple faxes to be sent and received at once and delivered to email. Get your voicemail messages instantly through email too. And take advantage of an endless supply of customizable features. Host My Calls can deliver the cloud. All of this technology with low upfront costs and not one penny in capital expense. It's time for a phone solution you'll truly love from Host My Calls. Call the number below.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
All right, folks, we're back, and you know, we've been talking for the last month or so about the celebration downtown, the ribbon cutting on the remodeling and revitalization of the downtown area. That happened on Thursday. We had an absolutely great time. There was a good crowd down there. We had music, face painting, food. It was just fun, and we got a little video down there. Even Abraham Lincoln showed up. Abraham Lincoln, in the middle of the political season, shows up in Tullahoma. What a guy. Let's watch this video, and you'll enjoy it too.
Downtown's decorated up today. It's the ribbon-cutting day for the new reworking of downtown Tullahoma. This is one of the new benches that have been installed, and of course there's going to be trees installed after the first frost. We have nice looking new light poles. It's a great time down here, and good deals, good things happening downtown. This is one of the new road signs, iron post road signs, and the slogan, it's happening downtown Tullahoma. There's a shot looking down the street, you know, with all the new iron posts and benches and road signs and stamped concrete on the sidewalks, and it's just a great upgrade for our downtown. Here's the front of Clayton Shoes right here, one of the oldest businesses downtown. And they're having a good time in there always. Things are decorated up.
There's Flo right there. Yeah, we in Clayton's right now. Wave to the crowd there, Jerry.
See who it is.
Mr. Jerry Sperling right there.
Hey.
One of Tullahoma's best.
That's right. Hey.
Hey.
We're having fun.
Good. President Abraham Lincoln has just come walking by. He's down here to visit all the people downtown. Abe, honest Abe. What do you think about the political season this time?
Oh, not a good one.
Not a good one.
I'd rather be back in the White House.
We do need you back in the White House, Abe. I guarantee you that's a fact.
Start all over again. Kick them all out.
There you go. My kind of man. Thanks for being here today, my friend. Problem. Couches downtown Tullahoma. And there's our friend Beach Grove Bob right there. Singing a few tunes out in front of the store. Yes, sir. It's a great day down here in Tullahoma, folks.
You sure look like the traveling kind. Well, don't stop. This ain't where you wanna be.
These are the new downtown garbage can receptacles, and it's happening downtown Tullahoma. It's got the logo on there and everything. These were made by the shop class at the Tullahoma High School and purchased by the Downtown Merchants Association. Don't they look good? Look, this is face painting out here in the park. Yes, it is. It's trick-or-treat time, and it's downtown. Have fun time. Give me a pretty smile.
Say cheese.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
Say hello. Halloween? Candy?
Hi. I was thinking about it.
Anything?
You gonna say hi, Brindley?
Downtown Tullahoma, and the mayor's here, and all the Downtown Merchants Association. We're having an open house today, and it's just a great, successful event that's being done in Tullahoma. There's musicians playing, face painting being done, and great deals from the Downtown Merchants Association. There's a basket of a gift certificate. There's $1,500 worth of gift certificates that'll be given away, divided into two baskets at $750 each. So congratulations, downtown Tullahoma. Ready to go. All the pictures are being made. It's happening downtown.
Smoking tobacco accounts for 3 of every 10 fire deaths in the United States.
Tullahoma Fire Department, Tullahoma Fire Department, need
22 en route to a structure fire, 202 Main Street. Heavy smoke showing. Neighbors advise child trapped inside.
Lighters, matches, and associated smoking paraphernalia are the leading cause of preschooler fire deaths. We as firefighters know that most structure fires can be prevented.
I've got one.
Command, this is primary search. We have a victim. Need EMS to meet us at the front door.
Please help us to give you a fighting chance. This can be prevented. Contact the Tullahoma Fire Department for a free home safety inspection.
What's a Tennessee vacation? It starts off like any road trip, and then, boom, adventure and thrills everywhere you look, which happens to be some of the most beautiful scenery in the country. Music here, history there, and all kinds of green in between. Come relax and unwind, or bring the crowd for some stargazing. Or stargazing. Whatever you do, come hungry and expect an awesome soundtrack. It's all right here in Tennessee. We're playing your song. For a free vacation guide, visit tnvacation.com.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
We're trying to always beautify our set here at this show, and today I've done it with Kelly Bradford.
Wow.
How great to have you.
That's so nice of you to say.
Kelly, most of you know her from the newspaper and the great work she does with Tempo and many of the articles you come out with, but now you are, what do we call you, the director?
Yes, the director. The Tullahoma Art Center.
Okay. But we're now calling it...
Well, it was the Tullahoma Fine Arts Center, but it's now the Tullahoma Art Center. So just changed the name.
Okay.
Yeah, very new.
Okay, and that's a big step. And for one thing you're doing is asking people to submit logos.
Yeah, so we're doing a community logo contest. We're really super excited about this. We wanted to do something to really let the community know that this is their art center. And we want them to help us in our rebranding and help us as we kind of move on to something different. So we came up with a logo contest. And
they have rules on that, like
we
size?
We do, and they're on our website at tullahomaart.org, or you can find us on Facebook. And or Instagram. We're also on Instagram too, so all that information's on there. It's open to any age.
That's good.
It is, yeah. And we wanted everybody just to kind of...
It can be... Well, they can go to that.
Yeah, they can go to three colors, not including black.
Okay.
So you can include the black. Something that's modern, you know, because we're moving into a kind of a new age.
Growing.
But really just want the community to use their imagination and think of the art center as a place for not only the visual arts, but the theatrical arts and the musical arts. Just an art hub, if you will.
I love that. I love the idea of us pushing all the arts in our community.
Absolutely.
Christmas, is that the next thing on your agenda?
Yes, so I have so many things going on. I had to write them all down so I wouldn't forget.
I'll just let you talk.
Yeah. Well, Pat Hitchcock, who's a local artist here in Tullahoma, terrific artist. She's hosting another acrylic class, so they're going to be painting a beautiful winter sled scene. Perfect for, you know, if you got to get, you know, a gift to give, want something to give a real personal touch. She's a ton of fun too. Just a really talented artist.
So she's having a class.
She's having a class on November the 16th. So we're taking enrollments right now. You can call the Art Center 455-1234.
That's easy.
Yeah, it's absolutely the most easiest phone number to memorize. Call down there and get scheduled. Also, the information is on the Facebook page and also the website. So
any type of art that you do, but she will.
It's
acrylic, obviously,
yes.
But.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
As far as if you need to have any skill, no.
Okay,
it's
that's
beginners
what I was trying to say.
Advanced. That's the great thing about the art classes. at the center. Anyone can participate, and we encourage anyone to come down. Oh, absolutely, because I think some people get a little nervous sometimes. You're like, well, I couldn't do that.
But absolutely, you can.
So.
Artists, what you produce that you love.
Yeah, and Pat and all of our artists down there at the center are really good at kind of giving you those steps to kind of lead you in the right direction of which where you need to be. We also have the Trees of Christmas exhibit. So it's the second annual. It's centered around the 12 days of Christmas, so the partridge and a pear tree. Yeah, and we've had local businesses, local artists, and just volunteers in the community.
I know you've had 4 or 5 already solicited. Have they been named, like, which day of Christmas they are?
We have, I can't remember off the top of my head.
Well,
because there's 12. But we have, for instance, the Community Playhouse will be coming in and decorating a tree. The THS and Profiteers, local artist Tommy Williams, and some other local businesses coming in. So another way to have the community coming
involved
in.
Exactly. And these will be presented.
Yes, they'll be presented, and let me look at they'll be presented on the November the 11th through the 26th to give the people enough time to come in. Now, here's the great thing. So not all of us have, Christmas is an extremely busy time, especially for those of us who work. And these trees will actually be for sale.
So they're auctioned off, sort of?
Yeah, so there'll be a silent kind of auction going on.
And you can just pick the tree up, go sit it in your living room, and you're
done. Actually, we'll do you one even better than that.
Oh, really?
We will deliver
it
to you.
That's wonderful.
Yes.
That is beautiful.
They'll have an opportunity to come by to bid on the trees. There'll be a buy it now option. Yeah. So if you're on eBay, you'll know that the buy it now option, just you can buy it right away. But all the proceeds go to the art programs at the center.
That's great.
Oh, yeah. So there was a great turnout last year. We're looking for an even better turnout this year.
And there's always a need for money when you're having a not-for-profit organization.
Yes, absolutely. Making the classes affordable for everybody, and that's another big thing. You know, we want everyone to come in and be able to take an art class at the center.
I love it. I do.
Awesome.
Yeah.
We also have something else, too. I'm just going to keep going.
Go ahead.
Barrett Hedges, who most of you know, who is a THS graduate, extremely talented photographer.
I know. National Geographic.
Yeah, National Geographic winner. He's a wildlife photographer. But to see his image, I mean, to even talk about him really doesn't even do them justice.
You have to see the images.
Absolutely.
It's amazing.
So he's going to be here. He'll open up November the 19th, and that is a Saturday. So it's from 5 to 7. We'll have an artist reception. We invite, obviously, the whole community to come out and see Barrett's exhibit. He will be there through the mid part of December. So you'll have lots of opportunities to come down there, take
see
a look at
work.
The trees, buy a Christmas ornament. We have so many things in the center by local artists for sale, too.
Yeah, there's nothing better than what our local artists do.
Absolutely, and we're also participating in the Shop Local event. So that's where every Saturday, if you purchase anything downtown or locally, you can take your receipts to the chamber and be entered into drawings.
Oh, how nice.
Yeah, so that includes
us. So they
us.
Have some prizes that will go with that drawing. That's
so
a clever idea.
We're in that, and we have this tons of great artwork and products down there made by local artists, and we encourage everybody to come in and check them out. I think you really will be surprised at all the cool stuff that's down there to purchase.
I love your enthusiasm. How long have you been the director?
Just 2 months.
2 months.
Today, actually.
You have been pushing and working
hard. Yeah, it's been a very fun experience. Lots of stuff I want to do, but we have to eat that elephant one bite at a time.
So exactly. We really do. And I think I would encourage always everybody to come in and see what's going on there. And, you know, maybe you're just sitting home on the couch and you don't have much to do. Go
Absolutely.
Take an art class, for heaven's sakes.
Yeah, we're scheduling art classes right now, trying to get ready for the December season. Also, you know, we have next year that we're trying to schedule for. So
now, if there's someone out there and they're a local artist and they would just like to come and maybe present their work for an art show, is that a possibility?
Yeah, absolutely. Obviously, just call the center. Let us, you know, we can meet up, take a look at it. I welcome all local artists.
Good.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. There is no small way that you can support the local arts. Whether it's inviting them to come down and take a look at the show or sharing a Facebook post or just saying, hey, let's go down here and let's see this exhibit
let's
that's opened up.
Let's see what's going on.
Yeah, absolutely. So.
What are the regular hours? hours of being open?
Absolutely. It's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday from 1 p.m. till 5 p.m. and then on Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m.
And then when you have a special event, that's advertised?
Yes.
And like the one coming up?
Yeah, and then it would be from 5 to 7. But go ahead.
They're going to turn us off here any second.
Okay.
So go ahead with your last minute.
Well, I just want to say thanks to the volunteers. Without the volunteers and all that support the Art Center, we could not do any of this.
So. And if you'd like to volunteer, give the Art Center a call.
Yes, 455-1234. Thank
Kelly,
you, Peggy.
I love having you here.
Well, thank you. I enjoyed
being
here.
You're doing a wonderful job.
Thank you.
We'll be back.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is the paint. I just knocked a tree over. This is the paint doctor. I got the color wheel. Now, you know what a color wheel is? It is the wheel at the paint works where you pick all your colors to paint your room. It could be a multicolored beard. It could be a underarm fan. You never can tell. One thing we do know is that it's time to paint. You know, you can make your wife very happy if you go to your house and paint some rooms, or you paint the outside of the house, the inside of the house. It makes them feel very good because you work hard for them and they like that. All women like to see their man sweat. You know, they do. Honeydew is what they do. And you get to do it, too. So you go to the Paint Works at 1960 North Washington Street, and you see Dabin Aikkonen over there, and he's the real paint doctor. He fix you up with color. It's so nice when the color is right. Go to Paint Works today, Martin Senor. See, Martin Senor, right there. Martin Senor out of the Paint Works. Bye, and we see you next time. I'm burning up.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
Hello, everyone. I'm John Rickman, and this is
Pat Welch, and we're here for segment 31.
Ain't
the
it
conversation
fun
with John and Pat. 31. Ain't it fun?
Pat, like we've talked before, we have no segue into what we're going to talk about, because this is going to be a silly, what I'm singing, but what we're going to talk about is not so silly.
Well, I've stretched a few of them. We'll see what we can stretch one
stretch
today.
They passed an ordinance in the town, said we'd have to tear it down. That little old house out back's so dear to me. Though the health department said its day was over and dead, it will live forever in my memory. Don't let them tear that little brown building down. Don't let them tear. Building down, don't let them tear that
in the country or the town. Well, it wasn't a castle fair, but I could dream a future there and build my castles to the yellow jacket's drone. I could orbit around the sun, fight with General Washington, or be a king upon a royal throne. Wasn't fancy built at all, it had newspapers on the wall. It was air conditioned in the winter time. It was just a humble hut, but the doors were never shut, and a man could get inside without a dime. Don't let them tear that little brown building down. Don't let them tear that precious building down. Don't let them tear that little brown building down. For there's not another like it in the country or the town.
Oh, that was fantastic.
Well, it's a little song that I learned probably in the early 60s. It was written by a fellow named Billy Ed Wheeler, who's been a successful songwriter in Nashville. But that's the sort of thing that I learned. Good. I don't know why it made me laugh. Makes me laugh today.
You gave me a little bit of a challenge, but one of the first lines, you said something about ordinances. And I'm going to talk a little bit today. We'll reminisce about Mr. Creed McClure, who, when he was principal, laid down several ordinances and enforced several ordinances. But Mr. McClure was really well known in the 70s, especially when he served on the legislative board of the TAA. And
Pat, let me interrupt just a second, because Mr. McClure and Ms. McClure were a teaching team.
Correct.
He coached, taught.
His wife's name was Blanche, and she was
nice,
a great teacher.
Great.
Yeah,
good personality.
Great personality, yeah. And he was tough as a pine knot, and she was soft and nice, sweet. They really complimented each other really well, I thought. He played football and was supposed to really, really been good at Tennessee Tech. And I thought he was, to me, looked like maybe when he was, when I knew him, when he'd been in his 50s and 60s, he was probably maybe 175, 180 pounds. But I thought he was a running back or receiver or something, but he was a guard, and they said he was really good. So he had to have been a pretty tough character. He was originally from McMinnville, and he coached at old McMinnville City for a while, but he came to Tullahoma either 49 or 50 to be the head coach at the old high school that's on the present East Lincoln Elementary campus now. And he had several decent teams, but he had a great undefeated team. I believe they were tied once in 1955. And he had several players that, one of which we'll talk about probably in our next segment. And after that season, 55, he retired from coaching, and Coach Cooper, W.C. Cooper, who we talked about here before, had been his assistant, I think, in 54, 53, something like that, and left to go to La Follette to be the head coach. As soon as he had a chance to come back to Tullahoma, he could hardly wait, and he came to Tullahoma in 56. But anyway, Mr. McClure went into administration, and I believe he was principal at West Junior High when it was first built. But it was soon after that he became at least in the mid-60s or so, he became principal at the high school. And he was revered. Our field house is named after him, and the fundraising for the field house was raised in his name. And I don't know what the present field house would ever been built if his name hadn't been put on it, because he was so well-respected. And I thought we could tell at least one story when I was...
Did we show Mr. McClure's picture?
Let's get that picture. This is a TSSAA legislative board at the time, and Mr. McClure is second from the left there, standing up. And that little serious scowl he's got on his face, if he looked at you in the hall like that, a man come to an abrupt halt, that's for sure. He called me in when I was a junior. I hadn't done anything too grievous, but for a little counseling session, and he knew me a little bit from...
He's trying to steer you.
Yeah. he knew me from playing football a little bit, and of course he would have taken a lot of interest in the football program since he'd been a past coach. And so he called me in and sat me down, and we covered several facets of life in general. And finally he got to the point where when he got real serious, he got a real gravelly voice, and he called you by your last name, and he says, "Welsh, you'll have to remember there was a time in my life where there wasn't a man on the face of earth I couldn't whip." And it like broke me out in a cold sweat, because I immediately thought, well, you know, if he could beat everybody 250 pounds on up when he was young, he could probably take care of me with 135 pound shrimp now. And I really watched what I said and did anywhere close to him for a long time after that. And I was probably in his late or at least mid 30s before I realized he used a lot of psychology on me then, and it was very effective.
It worked.
Yeah, it worked. He definitely made an impression on me that
Pat,
day.
We've got to end this today.
Well, that was still a great segment. Mr. McClure was a great man, and his wife was a great lady, and their daughter Beth was a great girl too. And that ends segment
31,
but it's not the end of the conversations. We've got several topics to go. Thank you.
For Healing provides medical care to the working uninsured of Coffee, Franklin, and Moore counties. We are in Tullahoma from 8 to 5, Monday through Thursdays, and in Manchester on Fridays from 8 to 12. We provide primary medical care and offer an in-house disease management program.
My name is Rosie Mitchell, and I would just like to say I am blessed to have partners in my life.
Please call 455-5014 for more information. Thank you for being one of our Partners for Healing.
Hello, this is Janie Price. When my husband Ray Price would tour across the country, his favorite place to dine was Cracker Barrel Old Country Store locations. His favorite thing to order was the Uncle Herschel.
And the beauty of it all is forever, you'll be holding me too.
I miss Ray dearly, and I'm so proud that his last album, Beauty Is the Final Session, is available at his favorite restaurant.
A love affair.
The project includes a duet with Martina McBride and harmony vocals from Vince Gill. Ray believed this to be the best recording he had ever made.
Oh, I wish I was 18 again.
I think you'll agree when you pick up your copy of Beauty Is the Final Sessions at a Cracker Barrel Old Country Store location near you or at crackerbarrel.com.
A world without breast cancer is a world with more birthdays. And signing up for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk will help us get there faster. The American Cancer Society invests in groundbreaking breast cancer research, and we're part of every community. In fact, one in two women newly diagnosed with breast cancer turns to us for support. Sign up today at makingstrideswalk.org. Together, we can finish the fight against breast cancer.
It's time to go to the zombie run now.
We had 12 runners today. We had 5 zombies that did a very excellent job because some of them were in 2 places along the course. We started at the Tullahoma Airport out here, and we were very grateful that the parishes let us use their beautiful land out there, and they ran through the meadows, and then they went through all the way back to the back part of the Beechcraft. And came around the Stagger Wing, and they finished back up here at the airport. And here are some of our wonderful zombies right here.
Well, for those who don't know, tell us what happens during a zombie run 5K.
Well, as a runner would come up, you would have a zombie suddenly attack them and brutally assault them and take their flags.
Their whole objective was just to, they have, go ahead, John, talk about it.
Basically, is they're kind of a defender in a flag football game. You run up, pull their flags, and get the runners off course a little bit.
And you can't, they couldn't tackle them or hold them or knock them down or be brutal.
No.
You know, they weren't supposed to be, so. And neither could the runners. The runners couldn't be brutal either. But anyway, this is John Neal, by the way. He's a program coordinator for Parks and Recreation also. This is Tammy Wiseman, one of our volunteers. And what was your name?
Jonathan Mars.
Jonathan Mars. So we're grateful to have all these. They did a great job. The best one was a little girl.
Had, Dr. Thomason's daughter.
Olivia.
Olivia Thomason.
Thomason. And she had about 8 flags in her hand, yep. So she did really great out there. So I think she's only like 12 or
something. She's in middle school, right, was infected late, and got out there, yes. And she did her part.
Yes, she did.
Okay, so is this an annual thing? Does this
it
happen?
It is. This is the second annual one. The last one they had at Fraser McEwen Park, but I think I like it out here. It's just so beautiful. We were grateful that we were able to do it in the meadows out there to make it like real life.
Nice environment. Zombies.
Yes, it was very nice. So.
In the landscape, it was scary.
It was a scary landscape. Yeah. They didn't know when, there was only 5 of them, and there was 3.5 miles, so they had 3.1 miles. They had no idea where they were going to be. And they got to move around. Tammy was one of the ones that got to move around, so they had no idea where she was going to be after they came out from the back of the stagger wing. So she had a big pine tree she was hiding behind. It was awesome.
Okay.
Anyway.
Well,
next year we'll have it again, and
even bigger.
Even bigger, hopefully. Yes, definitely. So it was a lot of fun.
Closer to a world with more birthdays. When we take cancer patients by the hand, we help them find answers and guidance and hope, and give them more candles to light. We're the American Cancer Society. Help create a world with more birthdays at morebirthdays.com.
Is this the year you want to get fit? If so, check out just some of the things Tullahoma Parks and Rec has to offer. Kickboxing, aerobics, silver sneakers workouts, swim lessons, boot camp, water aerobics, basketball, Zumba, yoga, pickleball, lap swimming, treadmill, karate. Get fit, Tullahoma, and have some fun with Tullahoma Parks and Rec.
When your family suffers the loss of a loved one, the caring and compassionate staff at Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel are standing by to assist you in every way possible. We are proud to support local industry and offer only Batesville caskets. Many funeral homes don't own or operate a crematory. We utilize the only crematory in Coffee County. Your loved one never leaves Coffee County. We can accommodate any need and any budget. Consider our complete pre-need service to remove this burden from your family during their time of grief. Lock in today's low costs and protect from inflation. Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel. Our family caring for your family.
camera ladies this morning. Appreciate y'all, your good work and everything. And this is a special time of year that we all want to cherish and remember that November the 11th, I believe it was 1919 at the 11th hour when World War I hostilities came to a close, and we've tried to remember that and celebrate the peace and freedom. That, of course, that was the war to end all wars, which, of course, did not happen. But in 1921, I think Congress or whoever the powers that be designated November the 11th as Armistice Day, which meant the end of all hostilities and peace that was supposed to be forever. Well, at any rate, we've been blessed by having celebrations to honor those that made the supreme sacrifice that we might indeed have an Armistice Day to celebrate and the freedoms of our country. American Legion Post 43 was established, I believe, in 1921, maybe 1919. I'm not sure of the date. But the Memorial 39 means that they honored 39 soldiers and military people that were killed in World War I from Coffee County, and that's where it gets its name. And Post 43 has been here in Tullahoma for all these many, many, many years, and it's an honor to be part of a group that wants to help some of the veteran comrades that can't help themselves, that are wounded or ill, and we're grateful to the Veterans Administration for taking care of those people. Now, we want to point out that this Saturday here at the American Legion there's going to be a November 11th celebration that we can be a part of and to honor those. Let me point out a picture that was taken in November the 11th, 1945. These were the first veterans that came home from the different services, and the American Legion Post and the World War I veterans hosted a dinner at the USO building on West Grundy Street, just two doors south west of the Tullahoma Municipal Building. And you can see in the background is the Learning Center, but there were some hundred or so World War II veterans that came and were honored that day at the first celebration as a group that were honored that came home in November of 1945. And as time, go ahead, Bob, and we've got some more pictures we want to share with you. This picture is of the American Legion band. American Legion Post 43 had a wonderful band, marching band that paraded in state conventions and local conventions, and won national honors. This particular picture was made in Chicago when they won the national championship of an American Legion marching band. We're proud of them. And back a few years ago, when we were in grade school in the 30s, on November the 11th, the whole school system would march up to Davidson Park and hear lectures and stories, and the bands would play, and they honored all of the veterans at that time, and then school was out for the rest of the day. The picture that you see now, I believe, was, yes, this is Gate 1 of Camp Forest. I made that picture in 1941, and Camp Forest came and was here from 1941 to 1946, and many of those soldiers took part in the local veterans programs here in Tullahoma. We thought they were a bunch of old men, but the truth of the matter was that they weren't but a year or two older than we were. There were some 890,000 soldiers in the woods between Lebanon and Lawrenceburg and other places on maneuvers that were a real important part of our history. This picture is a little bit out of order, but it still has to do with our armed forces, and this is a picture of the arrival of President Truman in July of 1951 that came for the dedication of Arnold Center. that was built on the same ground that the Army camp was, Camp Forest. And we enjoyed being there that day, and we're all looking forward to the 50th anniversary of Arnold Center next July. The program's planned for almost all year, and it's going to be a great show. Now, as we move right on, this is a picture of one of the USO. I believe this is a USO that's still standing, just two doors south of the municipal building here in Tullahoma. And they had bands. Each unit of the Army out at Camp Forest had a band. They loved to play at the USO for dances and for entertainment. And they were a great group of people. Most of them were from bands in out of Chicago, or big name bands. Now, as we go to the next picture, we want to emphasize that the which one is? Oh, this is one of the other USOs at the corner of Moore and Jackson Street. It was the former Davis home, and Mr. Davis had been the ambassador at large and also International Red Cross president, and that was the ancestral home of the Davis. Beautiful building, and it's now been razed, and there's a law office at that location. But the USO buildings, the Catholic USO was on the spot where the Tullahoma School Administration building is now. It burned in 1949, and the colored USO building was down on the location where the Tullahoma Utilities Board is now. And the building that we just saw of the Davis home was the Traveler's Aid and the Jewish USO building. And I think we're just about right out of time, but it's been fun to share this with you. We look forward to celebrating November the 11th here at the American Legion building at 11 o'clock. So if you can, come on out for that so we can honor those that should be honored. And in the case of bad weather or rain, this program will take place at the C.D. Thamps Community Center on South Jackson. And this is not all of the story, because there's a lot more to come. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.
All right, we'll see you next time, folks.